Ladies and gentlemen, tonight we're going to look at Terraform. And it is this introduction to Terraform, so do not be scared. It will not be that difficult. But first of all, what is Terraform? Terraform is a script. It's something that we can use instead of scripting, actually. Usually when we want to create something, and tonight we will something will be called a resource, like an S3 bucket. It could also be a Docker image. It could also be a file on your own drive. Then you would have to do a lot of checks. You would have to see, is the file already there? Is the S3 bucket already there? And then after doing all of these checks, then you can start creating. And first you need to log in to Amazon, if it's an Amazon S3 bucket. After that, then you can start to create. And then you can create your bucket if it's not already there. And then in the end, then you can close your connection, and then you're done with this. But it has been made much more simple, and it has been made very, very generic and modular. This means that we can actually just get there will be a provider for whatever we need to create, and if the provider is not there, then we can write it ourselves, and then of course we get a little bit of work. But in most cases, in most situations, people will already have created providers for us. For instance, for the major clouds like Google Cloud, Azure Cloud, Amazon Cloud, they have their own providers which they're maintaining, and this makes it very, very easy for us to create resources, also to delete resources, and to manipulate and change resources when we need to do that. So it is very, very easy. We save a ton of work. We save all the scripting that we usually do with Terraform. Trust me, if you haven't tried it, you need to try it. It will save you for a ton of work. First of all, we have something, and I'm only going to talk about the free version. This means that we get the client for free. There is also an enterprise version where you have a UI that you can log into, and where you also get some integration to LDAP and stuff like that. Also integration to HashiCorp Vault, because the creators behind Terraform is actually HashiCorp, and HashiCorp Vault, I really like that product too. The Terraform is just as easy and nice and smooth to use. You can really see that the developers behind HashiCorp, they actually know what they are doing. But first of all, we need a client. So we have a Terraform client. We install that on our system, and it's the way that we install it. Let me just show that right away, because that's always what I'm curious about. How do I install the client, and how does the main web page look like? It's terraform.io, and we can just press download client like this. And then we will end up in a situation with the screen right here. And then you just press whichever operating system you use. If you use macOS, of course you choose macOS. If you use Linux, which I'm using, then of course I choose the Linux 64-bit, which matches my operating system. If you're using Windows, of course there's also a version for that. Press that, and then you follow installation guide, install, and at some point then you will then have access to the Terraform client in your terminal, and then you are actually happy. Another thing is, if you're using IntelliJ, I will recommend you to use IntelliJ. Actually, it is awesome with the Terraform plugin there. It is it gives you a lot of help, and again, it will save you a ton of time. So if you are new, use IntelliJ, and I'm using IntelliJ Ultimate. I'm not sure. I think you can use actually Community Edition plus the Terraform module. I think that would actually also be sufficient. I like the Ultimate, then I know that I have whatever I need, because I'm also doing a lot of Spring programming. But let us go back to the screen right here. So after you have installed the Terraform client, then you can actually go out to a terminal like I have right here. And let me just clear it. Then I can write Terraform help like this. And then I get a list of commands that I can run. Init, validate, plan, apply, destroy. And these are exactly the commands that you are going to use. Usually, actually, after you have initialized your directory, then with init, then what you usually do is not validate. You will just use plan, apply, and destroy. And some people actually, they just use apply and destroy. Then the plan will automatically be called first. That is the plan for what is going to be created or deleted. And the validated will also be run automatically. So if you had created an invalid configuration, then you would be punished with a message about this, or blessed, because it's always nice to have or errors pointed out, right? So then we get smarter. That's how we become smarter, or become wiser, not smarter. What wiser? Yes. First of all, we have a main.tf file. That is where we have that's where we are defining our resources. What do we want to create? Do we want to create an S3 bucket? We also define our providers right here, because without a provider, we cannot do anything. We need these modules that some people has been so nice to write for us already. Then we have something called variables. Normally, I'm not going through variables today, but you could actually, in your folder, you could actually have a variables.tf file. And again, TF, of course, stands for Terraform. But we will not go into variables tonight. We will just write it as fixed constants. I'll make another video up regarding variables. Then we will get this weird file right here. After we call the init command, which we have right here. So after we go to a folder called init, then a state file will be created for us. And this will actually create an initial state. That means that it will actually assume that there's no S3. Let's say that we have a situation where we want to create an S3 bucket on Amazon, just to store and dump some files in. Then we would have a main TF file where we would have an AWS provider configured in it, and we will also have our resource configured in it. I'll show you how it looks in just some minutes. I have some more patience. It is a very short file actually, and this is what makes it so strong. But then we get this TF state file right here, and this is very important, because if you delete your TF state file, or if your state is out of sync, then you will be in problems and you need to solve that. I'll create another video about how to solve that. For now, just imagine that you're the only one accessing the cloud and you're only using Terraform. But let's say that you actually had a colleague that went in and deleted the S3 bucket. After the first Terraform creates this S3 bucket, then it writes into the Terraform.tf state file that the bucket has been created. And then you have a nice colleague that goes in and then he deletes this bucket without using Terraform and without committing the TF state file into your Git repo or wherever you want to keep this. When it's a shared Terraform system you're using, then the TF state file is actually out of sync, and it will actually try to create the bucket again, and it will actually get an error because the bucket already exists. But enough about that. I'll create a whole video about how to solve out of sync situations. For now, just know that you have a main.tf file. Do not be scared if your colleagues have created a variables.tf file, and do not be scared if there's a Terraform.tf state file. Do not delete that either. It is very needed. It is needed, and you can actually read this file if you open it up, and then you can kind of read and see what it actually happens. The first thing, create a new folder. That's step one. Then you call init, Terraform init. Then you would probably create this. You would actually probably start with creating a main.tf file. Then you would call init. Then you would call validate to check that it's valid. That's a nice thing to do when it's the first time. You don't need to do it the second and third time. Then you call plan to see what will be the consequences if I run Terraform apply. Then you can see all the consequences, what is being created, what is being deleted, and etc. What is being modified, because you can also, this is very strong when you want to modify stuff. Then we have this apply right here. That means that you can apply and add the resources. You can also destroy it all again with destroy. Now we have seen a lot right here, but the end result that we actually need is resources. And we can get Docker images, we can get Asia networks, we can get Google Cloud Postgres databases. You can get whatever you can think of out in the cloud. It is especially strong for the cloud, but you can also use it for local things, of course. Actually, this Docker image that I will show you in another video, this is actually local. You can create it for as soon as you have something you want to create, some resource, whatever you can think of, then you just need to get the right provider, and I'll show you where to get the provider. And then when you have the right provider, then you configure your main.tf file so it matches the provider, and then you can call apply afterwards, and then you can get your resource installed or created. Let us just see, how do I get a provider? Is this some magic thing? No, you go to register.terraform.io, and in this case right here, I search for AWS bucket, and then there's actually something called an AWS provider, and it doesn't just create the buckets, it can also create, it can create all of the Amazon's resources. And then I press this button right here, use this provider, there's this button right here in the right side, you can click that. Then you copy this part right here, and look, it's a lot of the beginning is actually copy paste. So what you do is you copy this, paste it into your the TF file. Here we have, you can see the source is this, that is the provider, and here we configure it. So we have a provider required, a provider installation area and or section, and then we have a configuration section afterwards. So actually, let us just start actually. So yes. So first of all, I have my TF. I have already created a folder with a lot of other subfolders in, but I'm going to create a new folder which we call AWS buckets. So we want to create, a new bucket in Amazon in AWS CD AWS bucket like this. Yes. And here we have no files right now. Then I go to IntelliJ. And now I have the file, and now I have the folder right here, and I'll right click, and then I'll say new file, and I'll just say main.tf. And the way I just want to tell you how I actually created this project, this is actually a Spring project. So I pressed file, new, and you, of course, you don't need to create a Spring project, but I just did that because I like Java, and suddenly I need something suddenly I want to run something in Java, and then it was just easier for me. I chose Spring Initializer, did SDK 15, I chose Gradle. I gave it a good name right here. Then I press next. I ticked off Lombok because I always use Lombok, and I also chose Spring Web. But you don't need to do that. It was just to get a project. What is actually important right here is the .tf files folder. And as usual, I'm going to upload this whole thing right here. Now I'm another thing you need to go, and of course you need to go to and install the Terraform plugin. So if you go to plugins, I can see now I can see that I have Terraform already. It's actually a JetBrains plugin, so it's it's part of it's part of JetBrains plugin. So that is awesome. If you don't have it, then you go to the marketplace, you search for it, and press install. It is pretty awesome because then what do we do then? So first off, the first thing you would do is you would create a main.tf file. You can see it gets a little icon that means that the your IntelliJ actually understands what's going on, and understands this file. The first thing you will do is you will copy this section from your provider, paste it in right here, and here we can actually configure whatever we want to. We can configure AWS. And the first thing you usually want to configure with AWS is the region, and I think central. Usually you would actually look these ones up. Europe 1. Usually you would look this one up in the documentation, and I actually did that. I just remember that it was Europe. You can actually also see, if you don't want to look it up, then you can use the default, which is, that's the default value right here, US East 1. But I want to check a European one. I think Central Europe 1 is Frankfurt. Frankfurt is very close to Denmark, so in Copenhagen, where I am. So that's actually, then you need to look, then you need to do something very boring. You need to read, well, how does this work actually? Here we are defining a resource. How do I create this resource? How do I log in? That's also usually a thing you need to look into. And the good thing with Amazon is that you can actually log in a ton of different ways. And I've created a video about this actually, which is called AWS Credential Providers. It is actually made for Spring Boot, but the principles are exactly the same for Terraform. We can log in static credentials. That means you give the username and password. We can set the user, and when I say username and password, I actually mean ID and secret key. That's how we log in with AWS. And then you can also set this ID and secret key as an environment variable. You can also use a shared credentials / configuration file. This is exactly what we're going to do because it's just much easier. And let us just do that right away. If you saw the other video that I created, then you would know that in the home folder in the .aws Then we actually can create a file named credentials, like I've done right here. I've already prepared it so we can save some time. And then you need to have a section or profile. You can have as many profiles as you want to. I could create a profile named Terraform administrator or something like that. Now I'm just going to use default, just because, again, it's easier. And I need to fill out AWS access key ID. If you're using environment variables, then this is the same. I think it's almost the same. You need to look up the keys for the environment variables if you want to use that instead. But you need to, no matter what, you need to fill out the ID and you need to fill out the key. And since I've already created a user right here, this is my Amazon console. I only have one user right now. This user is a member of the administrator access group. That means that it has a policy, which is named policy administrator access. That means that it has policies, so it can actually do whatever. You can also create your own group, and you can also create your own policies, which I explained in the other video named credentials providers for AWS. It is made for Spring Boot, but it's these things right here are generic. But what do we want to do here, right here? I want to add security credentials. And right here, I want to add an access key right here, create access key. And it's very important when you create the access key that you actually remember this key that you actually have right here, because you cannot retrieve this key again. Then you need to create a new access key. That means you need to delete this ID and key pair, and then you need to create a new one. So remember that, or do what I'm doing right now. Paste it into your file like this. And yes, I'm going to delete this key before I'm giving you the code, or else I'll get a nasty message from Amazon that my secret ID and access key was leaked. I've gotten some of those. Now I'm going to save this file right here. Credentials, 4 lines. So now I've actually written my credentials file. If I wanted to determine and set the file, then I could actually write share credential file, then I could point to the file. But the default value is actually the same as I'm going to write right here, home.aws/credentials, like this, credentials. So I don't think that you actually have to write this line right here. We're going to do it anyway, just because then you're telling the other developers that you don't have any environment variables. You have defined your credentials right there. It's information to your colleagues. So I'll say it's good to be explicit, even though that Terraform would actually look for, it actually has a list. First, it will look for in environment variables. Then it will look in that file. And it also has some other place that it wants. It would look for, maybe it's, I think it's Java system properties that it would also look in. So now we have the provider. So all of this is just setting up and telling Terraform what kind of provider do we want to use, and how do we log into the provider if it is needed, and which region should I use. That is this part right here. So now we go to the fun part. This is actually what we wanted to create. We go to the resource, and here comes actually, this is the syntax. And thank you very much, IntelliJ, for helping me with this. I'm not paid by IntelliJ or JetBrains, just so you know. I just really like their products. I'm a huge fan. You can create an AWS instance. That means that you could actually set up a new server. I've also done that with Terraform files. But for now, we would actually like to set up a bucket. There's something with a S3 bucket somewhere. It is actually right there, S3 bucket. And then the second part, I can use whatever name I want there. This is just the name. This is a logical name. So I could call it something like mics.tf demo.greatfiles1 or something like that. But you need to follow this. What does it say here? What does it complain about there? It must name. Must start with a letter or underscore or might. Okay. So let us just use underscores like this instead. So the next thing we want to do right here, the ACL. The ACL is always something that is being set, and we can set this to private or public. Public means that then everybody can actually reach it if they have the right credentials, of course. So that means that then you can create users that then can other users that can access your bucket. Then we have something called tags. Inside tags, there's something called name. And I can set this name right here to something like grade files one, like this. And that's actually it. Do I want to add other tags? I don't think so right now. Let us see if it's if I made any mistakes. I like to go out in the terminal when I run Terraform stuff. I could also run it. You can also run it from, of course, from. Can also open a terminal right here, right click. But I think I'll take the right, I want to have the real terminal right here. So we can see now right now I have a main.tf file. So the first, okay, I'll just go to the right side, sorry. Yes. Right side there, yes, I think it will be fine. And then the first thing we write is Terraform, then we write init. And then we get that the famous state file. So let us see what happens. Yes, Terraform has been successfully been initialized. Try to run Terraform plan. Yeah, let us do that. Terraform plan to see what changes would be made. Public. It doesn't like the public right here. Is this an... Let me just check right here. Not commas, okay. I think it's a public, it's the value itself. Usually actually I write private. Public read write. Okay. This is actually good help with actually writes right here. So public read write, public read, authenticated read, AWS exec read, or private. Let us not just set it to private. Actually, I would like to set it to private in this situation right here. Then I'm sure that I'm the only one writing in it. Let us just check right here. On left, okay, provider AWS, let me just check, there was an error right here, provider, required providers AWS, what is it complaining about here, invalid region, okay, the region is not right, is it, actually, let me just cheat a bit, of course I have another file right here. I have another variables file right here. EU, okay, it is EU central instead. I could look these up. It is in the documentation. And I could also try to, if I try to create a bucket manually, then I could probably also get these values right here. I would like that those have been, completed for me, but they're not shown to me. But let us try now with EU central one instead. And let us clear the clutter. Terraform plan. But I think it's very good feedback that the feedback comes right away. Okay, now we can see what is going to be created. So plus equals create. Okay, so now we have the explanation for that. So what are we going to create? We're going to create this resource right here, and our ACL is going to be private. False destroy false, and here we have a tag, the name equals to great files, and of course I have a spelling mistake right there. That's okay, then we can change that afterwards actually, so that is fine. I'm not going to explain to you what out is in this video. I'll show that in another video. That is, the short thing is that you can actually output different things. And then you can define out, but I'll show this in another video. Now we will run apply. This means that Terraform will perform the action described. Only yes will be accepted to approve. Yes, we write yes. Let us see what happened. Okay, we added one resource right here. So, and we did not get any credentials error. or security errors, that means that it actually accepted the ID and secret key. Let us go to let us go and write S3 right here in Amazon console, just to look. We want to see an Amazon console, of course, that it is there. And what it looks like, because we gave a tag that there was one name, and then we gave a logical name. Then we have, yes, this is the one. The name. What about the tags right here? Properties. It got a tag right here, got a name, great files one. That is okay, I guess. So we got our bucket right here. So that is actually our bucket. And if we go to our state, I think we could actually have given a name or something right here, I'll just go cheat again, sorry. I'll just go cheat here. Okay, buckets. I should have called it bucket something. Yes. The thing is that this name right here is only a Terraform logic name right here. So if we want to change the bucket name right here, then we should say this to Mike's great files one, like this. And then we can just change this to, let us call this two now. So now it's the second one. But it's still the same Terraform resource. That means that we want actually to rename the existing one, because it is the same Terraform resource. It's the same name, is the same reference it has there. And if I go to my Terraform state file, then I can probably also find that still. Yeah, we can see here it's right there. And we can actually see that we already created it. And that is its name. We can see the on name right there. That is the Amazon unique name. So let us go again, and then we say plan, and then let us see what it actually wants to do. It wants to change some things now, because we have changed now the bucket name. Sometimes it has to delete it. Let us just see here, plus minus, destroy, and then create replacement. So plus minus right here, it actually needs to create the bucket, needs to delete the bucket first, and then it needs to recreate it, because I have chosen that now it should have this name instead of the other name. So that's actually it. So let us just run apply, Terraform apply. Then again, we have to say yes. Right here. Creating, okay, and it's done. So it actually, again, look here, now we got another receipt. It destroyed one and it created one. So that means that it have deleted this one. Let us just refresh. I could also press the real refresh button. Look what it says right here, Mike's great files two. Mike's great file, and this is what I mean with the regions. If you are in any doubt, you can actually go create a bucket manually, and then you can actually take the values from there if you want to. And let us just look at Mike's great files two. Properties, and we have some tags somewhere. Here we have a tag named great files two. Tag names are easy to edit, but the name itself in Amazon, of course, then we have to delete it and then recreate it. I hope you can see how useful this is already. We have this Terraform file right here, and you see this is quite easy. This is just standard. We just copy pasted that part right, and then we have access to creating Amazon resources, and then we just define our resources here. And then, of course, we need to know that it's called bucket and ACL and all that. That's why we have the documentation that I showed you in the beginning. Here we have a lot of boring documentation right here, right? So, of course, then we'll go down and read about S3. S3 is right here. And then I can here we have the resource. Buckets, what should we have here? Bucket copy, we can also. Yeah, so here we can read about what we can do with the buckets. And here's a good example, actually. Here we have the bucket part right here. The downside with Terraform is and I actually think it's a good thing that you have to read the documentation per provider. So when we start with Azure, then we have to read the Azure provider documentation. But you only need to read the section where you want to create a resource for. So if you want to create a network, then you just need to read the section about network, and then you can see how to do that actually. Here we have a VPC. So if you want to create a VPC, then we can actually see that we could do that. Like that actually, default VPC. So if I add a resource like this, then I actually create a network, and let us just paste it right here. And I'll call it Mike's demo network. Then I know that I can just delete it afterwards. So like this, default VPC for TF demo one, like this. Then I can go out in my terminal again, and then we can go apply. And it's okay to create a lot of stuff because it is very, very easy. And here we can see that now we want to create the network. Yes, 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 a lot of stuff with some routes that we have not set up a lot of things, actually very few things. Enable DNS support, that's the only thing that's true. So now it's creating the network. It takes a bit longer with networks. I think that's actually why I chose to play around with buckets. And also buckets are very easy to understand. It's like a file share, right? You can place stuff there. But never mind. Now we go and look at VPCs. We should see our network. VPCs. Yeah, default VPC for TF demo one. So we can see how easy it actually is to create a resource. I read some documentation. Actually, I almost didn't read it. I just copy pasted it, and then the resource was created. Now let us try to destroy it all again. So now we are going to clean up after ourselves. We call it destroy, like this. And I press yes. And enter. Then we can see what is going to happen. We're going to delete those two resources, the bucket and the VPC. So now let's look again. I could press the button. I always press a 5, I don't know why. It's just a reflex, I guess. It is faster to click the little button right there. Okay, maybe it's not done yet. It is actually still there. It should actually have created the network. I don't understand why it is still there. Maybe it was not, I don't know. Maybe it was not able to delete it. Ah, it is gone. I need to be patient sometimes. It comes out, right? Look what that is. Is it set for deletion or something? Let us just check. Now we call destroy again, but nothing will happen because the state file will say that both the network is gone and also the S3 bucket. Okay, but that was actually, let us see if the S3 bucket is gone. The S3 bucket is gone. Could also delete the other buckets actually. Delete those. I'll do that afterwards. So I also need to be empty, so I need to empty them out first. Okay, but the bucket was deleted, but the network was not deleted. That means that if I press apply now, I'll probably get an error because the network is already there. And that means that our state file is actually out of sync compared to the real life situation. Mike's demo network. I'll just go check again. VPC. Maybe there was something I have misunderstood or something, VPC. VPC is Frankfurt, we have one, yes. Frankfurt. We still have one right there. Okay, it's a little bit weird with the VPC, but okay, default VPC for CF demo one. Let us try to destroy it again. Let's try. Let me just look in the state file. Here we have the that's a bucket, yeah. Let us try to look for the here we have the network. This is this ID right here. Let us I just want to check that it's the same. Maybe it's maybe I created one earlier. You can also change the name. Let us try that actually. Demo blah blah. Like this. And approve again. Apply. Then write yes. Okay, this actually that ID is 7771, so it is that one. Okay, it just doesn't disappear when we say destroy. That's the only thing that just buggers me a bit. So here we have blah blah. Yeah, it is that one. And then we say destroy. That's probably a good explanation on for that. I'll read up on that afterwards. So. And then we want to run that. And I'll see right here. You're still there. Okay. Thank you very much for watching. Have a great evening, and I hope you learned something. And hope to see you again soon. Bye-bye.